Welcome back to The Blend. You may know our next guest is Craig from the legendary Comedy Central show, Reno 911. Now Kyle Dunnigan is in Southern Nevada for the opening weekend of the legendary comedy Cellar, which after many years of making people laugh in a basement in New York City, it has opened up a new room at the Rio.
Hello, Kyle.
Hello.
Great to have you.
I'm so glad to be here, and I'm proud to be promoting this club.
Like a legendary club, and now we've got one.
How cool is this? I started in New York with this club, and they have three rooms in New York on one block, and they're all sold out every day, three shows a day. Now it's in Vegas.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm not TV ready.
No, why are you not like you're TV ready?
Well, I'm looking in the white socks and then the dad shoes and then the sweatshirt.
Just don't look at yourself. You can borrow some of Sean's makeup if you want.
Yeah, I didn't put any makeup on.
It's okay though. That's for liberal.
Yeah. You feel better now?
No, I don't. I'm seeing myself in the monitor. I just got really uncomfortable.
This is what our rescue dogs do.
And I have rosacea. All right, just stay on. Two shot on the hosts.
Comedy, I am a huge comedy fan, and I know for sure Comedy Cellar is like, that's like at least East Coast, Mecca for comedy. I mean, that is where every comedian worth their salt, you never know who's going to stop on by.
That's how it got huge, is celebrities keep dropping in, because there's such great shows, and the audiences are, you know, excited, and there might be a drop in this weekend.
Ooh, a little tease.
Tease it up. $25 for locals.
Awesome.
Which you'd have to pay a lot more to see who's coming in.
Did you have a show last night? Did you see the room yet?
Yes, we did two shows last night.
It's different above ground, isn't it?
Above ground?
Yeah, well, it's not saying you're not on stage, but no, it's usually in a basement.
Yes.
Now you're up above.
The original room is very small, and it's also like the crowd's there and there. There's not much in front of you, so a lot of the times you're just doing that.
Yeah.
But they have two other rooms now in New York that are bigger, and you know.
Well, they need to. So many people want to.
Yeah.
So the room here in Vegas now, how nice is it?
It's real. They actually brought the New York vibe. And
it feels like it's the same club. Is there brick and black walls?
There is.
See,
there's brick, and there's some, you know,
woodage.
below the brick, there's some woodage.
I don't know.
Wooden paneling.
All right. So one of the questions we were thinking asking you is, you know, do you have a memory of the first time you performed at the original Comedy Cellar?
When you said that, I was thinking the first time I ever performed, I was in high school and I got suspended.
No!
Yes.
Why?
It wasn't even bad. My mother was in the audience too. Like, I wasn't very dirty, but I said an anatomically correct word for the male stuff.
The hoo-ha.
And then, it was a very uptight school.
You got in trouble.
Yeah, but it was a word you could say on TV. I'm not saying it now.
Yeah.
It's early. It's too early.
No one wants to hear that. You know. After 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we're all
prepared. You let it fly. Yeah,
but I don't remember first performing at the Cellar.
Now, did you think it was funny, though? And then it didn't go over well, the word?
Oh, did it get a laugh at the time?
Well, the thing is, the students were laughing. That's all I cared about.
Yeah. Okay.
But the administration wasn't
pleased. Isn't that always the
case? None too pleased.
Yeah. So you made in good with your peers, though, so that was good.
I got the attention I needed.
Have you reached out to the principal since then and said, hey, by the way,
no,
look where I am now?
We shan't be speaking.
You know what? We're going to cut this clip and we'll send it on to your school.
Maybe you could bridge the gap.
Yeah,
that would be great.
We're going to heal a wound for you.
That would be fantastic.
Bridge, as it were, between the two of you.
I was about to tell a story. I'm not going to.
Oh, why?
I don't think I can.
Why?
It's because it's early. Oh. All right, I'll say it. Then you could
we
cut
have
it.
Like
it.
Yeah, no, seconds.
Come on. Okay, so anyway, this principal who suspended me, we did this prank where we had snow in this courtyard, and the whole school was facing this courtyard. We made a giant, like, anatomically correct.
Phallus?
Phallus of a man. And we poured water on it so it was solid ice, like a penisicle. And then she came out, and we're all already laughing, and she was this tiny lady who knew karate, and she was trying to karate kick it down. Which, if there was social media back then,
cell phones,
everyone would be filming.
But this was before.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
So I got some sweet redemption.
We're going to have to find this woman.
And then she went back inside and got a bat, and with the bat, she got it down.
Wow.
Boy, is that symbolic.
This is some of the fun you get to see at the Comedy Cellar, which is now here in the west side of the lovely country. It's great having you, buddy.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you
so much. world famous comedy cellar. This is like Mecca for comedy. If you're a fan yes. of comedy, you got to get down to the Rio All Suite Hotel and Casino. It's opening this weekend. Comedian Kyle Dunnigan's going to be there, among others as well. Tickets are just $25 plus taxes and fees for Vegas locals. Got to show that local ID to get yours. You go to comedycellar.com. You can also follow Kyle on Twitter at Kyle Dunnigan.